Hello students of class 8. Today I will start the fifth video and we will start from drizzle. Drizzle. Sometimes very small droplets of water about 0.5 mm diameter falls on the earth, usually from stratus cloud. These drops are so light that they float in the air and are merely be felt. This kind of precipitation takes place when saturation of air takes place near the earth surface. So, when our droplets become 0.5 mm diameter and they comes from the stratus cloud, that is called drizzle. Now, what is snowfall? Snowfall occurs in the cold region in the high mountainous part when temperature falls below the freezing point in the upper atmosphere. The water vapor condenses directly into snow and fall down on the earth's surface because of the gravitational force. Next is hail. Snowfall done. Next is hail. All these definition you have to read. What is hail? In tropical region, clouds may have huge vertical extent. Cloud may be very huge. Okay. At the top of the cloud, temperature may fall below the freezing point. So, water vapor changes swift into crystals. And it come down on the earth accompanied with rain. It is called hail. It is not suitable for the crops. Next one is sleet. Sleet is another form of precipitation. When ice particles or hail fall on the ground and drops, it is called sleet. So these four definitions you have to read. Drizzle, snowfall, hail and sleet properly. Whatever I am marking, you should read this from this part. No diagram is needed. Only the definition part. You should go through this part. Definition. Now next definition is dew. Dew. On a winter night or a cloudless night, when the land releases heat rapidly, the layer of air adjoining the earth's surface cools down quickly, so small droplets are formed near the earth's surface and it is called dew. Dew is mainly commonly seen on grasses and leaves of plants. So again I am telling that when dew occurs on winter morning, or it accumulate, it is seen in winter morning. In a winter night or a cloudless night, when the land releases heat, during that time the land releases heat and the layer of air adjoining the earth surface becomes so quickly cooled down, so droplets are formed and the droplets accumulate on the grasses, on leaves, they are called dew. Next definition is, what is fog? What is fog? Sometimes water vapor in the air near the earth surface condenses into water droplets and gathers on the dust particles and suspended as smoke, and it is called fog. Fog affects visibility problem. Fog, when too much fog occurs, it causes visibility problem mainly in the winter morning and or in the during the night time also. Next, very very important that why dew and fog are not considered as precipitation. They are not precipitation. Why they are not considered as precipitation? Dew and fog do not form precipitation as they do not thrown down from the atmosphere to the earth's surface. They are not coming from the atmosphere to the earth surface, but they are formed near the earth surface in the lower atmosphere. They are formed in the lower atmosphere. They are not thrown from the atmosphere to the earth surface. So dew and fog are not considered as precipitation. Very, very important. Last part, which instrument is used to measure rainfall? That is rain gauge. Only the name is enough. Only read the name. Which instrument is used to measure the air temperature? Rainfall. Rainfall is measured by rain gauge. And last of all, what is isohyte? Isohyte. What is isohyte? Isohyte are imaginary line drawn on the map joining the places having same amount of rainfall. Region receiving same amount of rainfall can be joined by an imaginary line known as isohyte. So the chapter is finished. So from the last part, again I am repeating, read the definition of drizzle, snowfall, hail, sleet, dew and fog. Next part, why dew and fog are not considered as precipitation. Why dew and fog are not considered as precipitation? Which instrument is used to measure rainfall and what is isohyte? Isohyte is the imaginary line drawn on the map joining the places having same amount of receiving, the places receiving same amount of rainfall can be joined by an imaginary line known as isohyte. Okay, so this is our last video of the chapter cloud and rain. Already 5 videos given, so you should go through the videos. Okay, and thank you, class.